while the Veloster's nothing new, this 2016 model is something a little bit different. It's been refreshed, and this Rally Edition is completely new. Sure, this is a hatchback, and maybe in some eyes, it's a hot hatch, but you know, we should have a look at this Veloster in context, because it's a different take on the hatchback, it's a different take on the whole hot hatch concept, but it's not as hardcore as other cars in the segment. The thing about this Rally Edition, and what makes it interesting for me, at least what piqued my curiosity and why I wanted to drive it, is because it's actually a tuned version of the Veloster. It's a factory-tuned little hot hatch, and it's, you know, it doesn't have the wick totally dialed up, but it's got a few things that do make it more compelling than the regular Veloster. For one thing, it's available in one specification, starting with the striking and unusual matte blue paint and contrasted by an abundance of black trim. The black 18-inch raised wheels lend a purposeful look with their straightforward race-like design, and they're lightweight too. However, this car hits a home run with its thoroughly revised suspension, with unique anti-roll bars, springs, and most importantly, dampers. Dynamically, these suspension changes really transform the handling of the Veloster. I was never really impressed with it before, but here I'm actually enjoying it, and it gives me some confidence. I'm totally at home with this setup, and you know, I'm really surprised that Hyundai's done such a great job with such a little interesting car. It's kind of neat. I'm kind of blown away because it's Hyundai, and I don't expect this kind of suspension tuning from Hyundai. Who knew? I think perhaps the biggest improvement in this Rally Edition package is the B&M short shifter. It works really, really well, and the gates are well defined. The shifter works very well here, and it's better than most OEM units. The one thing this Rally Edition doesn't address is the engine. It's still the standard Veloster turbo, and you know, it's perfectly adequate. There's not an abundance of power here, but it's perfectly adequate for this application. The Veloster is still a bit of an oddity with its three doors and, you know, interesting styling elements. It's not as a cohesive as a design as they could have put together, but it's not bad. Yes, it's still a little quirky, and that's fine. I think some people like that. It is still very usable, however, and there's actually a decent amount of room in here. In fact, I think it's bigger than what I think its immediate competitor would be, which is the Fiesta ST. Now, it does lack the big Recaros that you can get in the Fiesta, but there's a little bit more room here in the cabin. The Veloster Rally Edition and the Fiesta ST are a near match in terms of power to weight. However, here in Canada, the Fiesta rolls out of the showroom at about $3,000 less than the Hyundai. At $27,000, this Veloster's pricing aligns it with the Focus ST at its price of just under $28,000. However, the Veloster doesn't suffer from the tragic torque steer like the Focus. On the other hand, a base Volkswagen GTI, the gold standard in hot hatches, costs a mere $1,500 more than the Rally Edition. While the matte paint and the black wheels and the Rally Edition name is a little bit boy racer, this is actually a decent approach to optimizing this Veloster's performance. It works really well. It's not over the top, and I think realistically, it's what most buyers in this segment are looking for. They're not looking for something as hard-edged as the Fiesta ST in most cases. I think this serves the market very well, and it's not too hard to live with either. I've got to give Hyundai some credit here. It's actually fun to drive. Thanks for watching this short piece on the Hyundai Veloster Turbo Rally Edition. That's a name, isn't it? But you know what? I'm blown away by this car. I didn't think it was gonna be as fun to drive as it actually is. So if you're looking for something in the segment, try this, let us know what you think. As always, we wanna know what you think about these videos, so please leave a comment below. And if you did like this, be sure to click like, share, and subscribe. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you again next time.